y'all don't mind, let's go back to a time we really used to have church. We used to have a good time, praising the Lord, in spirit and in truth.
I love them old
church. That old brother, pick up that old hymn book and
singing,
you knew exactly what he was gonna say. Sisters got happy.
I love them old church.
Folks start patting their feet, clapping their hands, and
singing,
all of a sudden, he break off in a song, something like this.
I want to glean from the subject matter, warning is not over. Warning is not over. If I had to use a subtopic, I would call it salty spirits. Salty spirit. Yeah, that's not just salty. Here we find in this text a very salty spirit. Brethren, the spirit has a reason to be salty in this text because he was put out of his own house. Amen. I don't know about some of you, but as a man, I wouldn't feel good that something had the power and strength to evict me out of my own house. But the text says that this salty spirit, when it found itself evicted, was walking the streets and looked around and wondered in dry places, thought back to itself, that's my house. And said, I will go back to my house where I came. After all, I'm familiar with the furnishing there. I'm aware of where things are. I even know where the key is. And I will go back in and I will set up shop. But when the salty spirit got back to the house, he found that the house had been swept and cleaned. And the spirit looked and realized he had a task on his hand. Turned around, the Bible says he went and got seven more spirits, more wicked than he was, and returned back to the house. And frighteningly enough, the text says they entered in. And Jesus says that his last day is worse than his first state. The spirit in the text represents the demonic working of the enemy. The house represents you in your introduction and relationship with Christ. Remember that we are the house of God. We are referred to through the scriptures. In 1 Corinthians chapter 16 and chapter 6 and verse 19, we are the house of God. We are seen as the body of God, the body of Christ. And so Jesus teaches a lesson in a parable demonstrating that once he comes in, he will clean the house. You know what I'm saying? Because many of us, before we met Christ, had some filthy houses. And we had some dirty stuff in the house. Amen. We didn't keep house well. Y'all I say, man, before you met Christ, you didn't act like you act now. You didn't do stuff. There was no control of you. You pretty much let the good times roll, and you gave yourself over to a spiritual presence that had the house unclean and unfit. And when you met Jesus, the first thing he did is said, we got to clean up and put stuff in place. The text says that, in so many words, when Jesus comes into the picture, the first thing he does is he starts an eviction hearing. y'all missed that. You won't be and cannot be the same person you was before you met Christ. When Christ comes into the picture, the first thing Christ does, he evicts that which is not supposed to be there and instructs it to leave the house. And the only way that spirit can get back in the house is if you let the spirit back in the house. When he got baptized, he needed to understand that God washed him in the water and grave of baptism, and the Bible said he was added to the church and got clean house. But his house. He's angry. He's mad. And I don't care about you, but if some other man come in your house and put you out of your house and start eating dinner in your house and wash your clothes in your house, you're going to be ready to raise some hell when you get back. Y'all look at me like I don't know what I'm talking about. Get for me Luke chapter 11, 23. Because you'll find in this text that God says that I'm so bad, I'm so tough, that I'll come in your house and take stuff and put stuff out of your house. And you remember in the book of Matthews when he came into the temple and found the temple was filled with those who defiled the temple. You remember the first thing Jesus did is begin to beat the money changers and clean house and move some furniture and put them out of the house, because Jesus is a bad, he's a bad man. He don't play around. When he come in the house and you want Jesus to have, he'll put you out of the house. He'll stand for no foolishness. He'll tolerate no silliness. He comes in, he'll set up shop and take over your life. Yeah, so you like chocolate. Jesus said, chocolate not good for you. No chocolate. And he'll throw chocolate out the house. Y'all say amen. Yeah, you like too much fried food. You ate enough chicken yesterday. You ain't made chicken. No more fried chicken. Yeah, so we serve a bad gym. I'm right about it. Oh, but I've been wrestling with this thing I've been wrestling with for so long. I can't be. You ain't got to be. Jesus will clean it up for you. Somebody said, Jesus will fix it for you. Yeah. He'll walk in the house that the devil has set up shop in your house for 25 years, 35 years, 40 years. I was smoking, drinking, I was doing all this stuff. I was captured by the devil. He had me doing what he wanted me to do. I succumbed to his power, but then I met Jesus. Yeah. And it made everything all right. That's why I'm not surprised. I'm sitting down sometime and I'm hearing people talk, and they tell me, well, how'd you get clean? Well, I went through a 12-step program. You lying, you ain't clean, you just ain't using right now. How you get clean? Well, you know, I just change people, places. That you lying, you just ain't talking to them right now. Your connect got locked up. You'll be using again. It won't be long. But when I hear folks say that, I'm gonna tell you what happened to me. One day I was minding my own business, and all of a sudden, I turned away from it. It must have been Jesus, because I couldn't have did it by myself. And when Jesus got through, I didn't want that stuff no more. Yeah, now he cleaned. Because when he cleans. And he don't leave it up to you to do the clean. He'll clean it by himself. Amen. Y'all ought to say amen. Oh, but look at the text. In verse 22, the Bible says, let me drive back. There's Jesus talking. He says what? Jesus is stronger than your devil. Right. Y'all, I say amen. Yeah. Jesus strong in your death. If you'll succumb to Jesus, if you'll trust Jesus, he said, but when a strong man walk in. y'all listen, this is a good teaching right here. Here's your problem. You was bad by yourself, and you were running stuff, man. I'm right about it. Right. But when she called Jesus and he walked through the door, all that old hidden stuff had to stop. Because there's some furniture moving out there. There's some furniture moving out there. Boy, Jesus got to laying off jobs and busting inside your head and touching your hollow bone, and you laying around for you broke out the house running, fleeing for your life. And now you're walking around. Man, she wouldn't let me in my own house. She got a T.O. on me. A temporary restraint order on me at my house. But the text said, but when a stronger man come in your house, not only he come in your house, he'll do what? He'll do what? Read.
And overcome him.
He'll overcome you. Now I like this, because he didn't say to overcome it. Mm-hmm. He'll overcome you. Mm-hmm. Because half our problems is that we think we somebody. And the first demon he got to deal with is you. Because we'll think we smarter than him. So he said, I'll come in your house and I'll overcome you. When I overcome you, it'll take care of whatever your it is. All right. Because when I overcome you, I'm going to take your it and divide your spoils. Ooh. With folk around you. That's why somebody driving your car now. That's why somebody walk with your lady now. Because I couldn't tell you nothing. You thought you was it. And God said, I come in there, I whoop you, I take everything you got and give it to your friends. Right. Y'all, I say amen. Yeah. Somebody got your Sega Genesis right now. playing Call of Duty right now. You play too much. You can't whoop you. Am I right about it? I'll be where you want me to be just a minute. But I got to say something. I got to help somebody right now, because what I need you to understand, that just because you've been saved don't mean that the enemy has given up on you.
All right.
Just because you've been baptized doesn't mean that the old you is just sitting there going quietly in the night. The text says that if your spirit, that old you, is wandering in dry places, nothing feels like home to him. And he says to himself, I'm going to go back to Brown because I know him. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to knock on, and I'm not going to knock on the door. I'm going to enter in. Mm-hmm. And here's the problem. Here's the problem. Okay. When there is an eviction and you've been evicted, the only way you can get back in that house, you have to have a legal right to go in. You have to have a legal right. If they evict you tomorrow, they put a sign up, sheriff office, according to Penal Code 5525-2016, been evicted, can't come in this house. You cannot go back in that house without a legal right to go in that house. When God cleanses the soul, cleanses the spirit, Satan has to use the law to go back in the house. He's not just letting. He argues arbitrarily he has a right to his house. He'll look at Jesus and say, listen, I know that Mojo got baptized. I know his wife got baptized. But according to the law, the Bible says in Romans 3:23, the wages of sin is death. And according to Romans chapter 5, that once death, once sin enters in, death follows and death enters into the world. I have a right to enter into that house because it's sin in that house. Y'all miss that thing. Yeah, it's just a little drinky. They don't hurt nobody. But when you start messing with the devil, he said, I got a right. I know you cleanse it, Lord. I know I can't whoop you. But he opened the door for me to come in. I thought I said something. He has no power over you. He has no authority over you. Jesus has all power and authority. And when he comes in, he brings in stuff worse with him than what he left with. Don't you know the reason that you are disrespectful to the house of God and the man of God is because the devil came back with seven more spirits, the spirit of disrespect, the spirit of covetous, the spirit, get from it, Galatians chapter 5, verse number 17. I want you to say, when he comes back, he's not playing because he knows he almost lost you. And since you gave him a legal right to come back into your life, he demands from God, and God has to obey the law because God cannot lie, nor God sees him. And God says that when you hold for me, I will teach you at Romans 6, verse number 13. You get from Galatians 5, 17. Say amen when you have it. I want to show you something.
Amen.
Because I'm going to tell you something. I don't believe that there's a spirit in this house right now that can't praise God.
Amen.
I believe that there's a spirit in you that won't praise God. I don't believe there's a spirit in here that can't shout, thank you, Jesus, every now and then. I don't believe it's a spirit here that thinks it's all right to just stretch out on the, to just lay down and just don't give God any glory. I don't believe it's a grown person in here right now that don't know how to shout thank you Jesus when they know God's word is speaking directly to them. Am I right about it? I don't believe it, but I believe there's a spirit in some of us. And I'm going to tell you something. The sad thing about the spirit is that he didn't break it in. You let that spirit in. Just because you got baptized did not insulate you from the attacks of the enemy. And the enemy said that when I get up and I get lonely, I'm coming back with me. And if you still got that Jesus in there, I'm going to get me seven more and we're going to come in there and take the house by storm. Oh, praise God. Amen. And watch some of my way. You know, I got two or three personalities. You got two or three demons. And that demon will come back. It's just one of you. But he brought seven more of them. And they come and they raise in hell. Can't nobody have what to deal with you. One minute you're acting like the next minute. Nobody know what you're going to get. You might just stab somebody's head for no reason. We don't know how to deal with you because you got some stuff. Amen. Y'all all right?
All right.
I'm trying to preach the service. I can sit down. Diana gave me to sit down and say, I need to hear up. All right. So what? Now listen to this. The enemy, he doesn't have authority over your spirit. You have no business sad, down, distraught, unless the enemy brings a spirit that quenches your spirit. You have to allow him in your spirit to mess you up or you won't praise God. Because it's a spirit that won't praise God. And I don't care what you say or how you fix it. He didn't break in. You let him in.
Well,
listen to the Bible. He has no authority. Romans 6, verse number 13, the Bible says what?
Neither
he said, neither yield yourselves, your members, what?
As
instruments of unrighteousness of what?
Unto sin.
Unto sin. Hold on. He said, don't even yield. The house is clean. Look at your neighbor and say, the house is clean.
The house is clean.
The house is clean.
The house is clean.
The word of God said, don't even play with it. Don't yield yourselves, your members, as instruments that's to be used as unrighteousness. Don't even take a chance. Don't look at the people. Don't look out the window. Don't crack the window. John chapter 10, the Bible says that every man that comes to my Father coming through me. He said, but a robber, a thief, and a murderer came in through some other window. I am the door. No man coming through the Father except by me. If that burglar got in, he got in because you left the window trying to air out some warm cookies.
Yeah.
Hey, he climbed in and said, yeah, do I get back in here? I knew you always open this window up at 2:00. You always open this window. What you mean? You know I sell this stuff over here. And you always seem to walk by here when I got my board. You know you want some of this stuff. I knew you'd be here. Is it not to hear yourselves? Instruments of unrighteousness. Read. The next one, he says what? Keep reading.
But
yield yourselves
to God.
Unto God. All right.
As those that are alive from the
dead. All right, alive from the dead. All right.
And your members of instruments of the righteousness.
All right, lead yourself to God. And then what? He said, don't you know that whom you yield yourself over to whom you let use you is to whom you belong. Whether it is sin unto death or to God unto righteousness. Every day you get up, you might not spend the whole day doing bad. He said, when you just yield yourself over just a little bit, the enemy can take over. When you just lean just a little bit, the enemy will take over. Before you know it, something that was going good, the whole day be messed up, full of dark, full of evil, full of all this stuff. Because when he comes back into your life, he does not come back by himself. You thought you had a problem, but now you got seven more problems than you had in the first place. What kind of problems can he bring back into your life? Revelation chapter 5, round the 17th verse, the Bible says what?
For the flesh lusts against the spirit. And the spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary ones,
they can't live together. You hear that? He said the flesh lusts against the spirit. The spirit against the flesh. They're contrary one another. They cannot live together. They can't live in the same house. Whenever you have the flesh and the spirit in the same house, there's going to be some fraudulent movement in the house. The contrary one, they don't like each other. God don't like it. Leave the shoes out in the wrong place. Pass wind all out in public and do all kinds of leave. Won't wash his dishes. And God, you got to get up out of here.
Amen.
And then he didn't just come back by himself. He brought seven more people. Whenever you starting over something new again, you need to understand, just because you made it through the program, just because you got baptized, does not mean that it's over. Just means he's reloading on you. He doesn't believe one bit that you changed. Your mother may like it, your sister may like it, but that devil said, I know that's my house. I know how he thinks. I know what she likes. And if I can get back in there, I tear up everything in there. I tear it up. I can just get in. And I'm waiting to get in. I can't get in right now. He got that Jesus in there. He's busting my mouth and hitting in my nose and stuff for no reason. He won't let me back in. But if he ever opened the door, I'm going to get him because he got me beat up. Demon out there fixing his shirt.
Amen.
Yeah, you better hide behind Jesus.
Amen.
Now you had to hit, you snuck. You had to sneak me. You know, He'll pump. He had to get seven more devils. To come not deal with you, but to deal with the Jesus.
Amen.
The Jesus that's now in you. How he get in you? When you were baptized, the Bible said in Acts 2:38, you received the gift of the Holy Spirit. When you were baptized, now John can declare in John, 1 John chapter 4 and verse 4, greater is he that is in thee than he that is in the world. He is bigger, he's better, he's better, he's stronger, he's more powerful than any problem you got, and he don't you knock on this door no more. Yeah, but Jacob, I don't care what, I'll take care of her or him, but don't you knock on my door no more. Yeah, all right.
Amen.
Now this going on the spirits, brother. You sitting there, all you got to do is just stay behind the cross. And that's all you got to do, just stay behind the cross. Don't let him fool you. Because if he gets a legal right to get in, he can go to the judge and say, Judge, he's guilty. Revelation chapter 10, he said he stands before the judge and he accused the brethren day and night. And he holds God accountable to his word, for it is impossible for God to lie. And what he says is that, God, you said that if they play with me, I get to get them. And then guess what? He opened the door. When he opened the door, he named the fruits of the flesh. He brings this stuff inside. And you wondering, man, how did I get into all this stuff? How did I get like this? And what happened to me? I'm going to tell you what happened to you. You gave him legal right to come in. And you give him legal right to come in your relationship, you'll be in a menage a trois before you know it. And you know you ain't never like no foolish like that till you saw it on TV and lost your mind. But as an Afro-American, we don't play no menage a nothing. I barely eat macaroni and cheese. I ain't doing no menage a with nobody. You get shot in my house talking about some menage a. Amen. But so that stuff come from somewhere. What is a menage a trois? What kind of foolishness is this? Your first problem, you were acting before marriage. That was one problem. But when the devil get through with you, he'll have you acting with everybody else in your marriage. Seven times worse than you were. Look at Galatians. Watch the Galatians chapter. Are you there yet? I want to see this. That chapter 5. I want to hear the fruits of the manifestation of the flesh is what? I want to hear those very quickly. Go up to about verse number. Go down about verse number. 19, what's the Bible say?
Now the works of the flesh. Which are manifest
meant that they might not have been there at first.
Yeah.
Are y'all with me?
Amen.
Let me tell you something. When you were little, you was bad. You was bad. So how many of y'all been fighting since you was 8? We won a lot of fights, didn't you? How many sisters have beat up some brothers when they were little? Tell the truth, brother. But Diane beat up her boy. She done beat up her boy. What he did? We should have been playing. What'd he do? Yeah, what'd he do to you when you beat him up? The little boy that you beat up?
Took her son.
He should have got beat up. That's what he did. Who you beat up, Sisha?
I beat up my boy.
Yeah, you know, you were little, you were bad. You know, my grandkids bad and bougie over there. You know, we were bad. We get into some stuff. Yeah. But we weren't this bad. Amen. We weren't like this. We didn't act like this. Where'd that come from? Our mamas and daddies didn't teach us this stuff. No. Our mama didn't teach us to lay around and don't clean up. Mom and dad to teach us to sit around and try some of the stuff that we see that are done in America today. Something happened between where we started from and where we are. Well. And somewhere along your journey, the enemy said, it's not over. Somewhere I entered into a relationship with the enemy. And I made an agreement with the enemy in which I have reneged on at the side of the Father Jesus. And Jesus said, and I'm coming back to the house again. But praise God, we can count on Jesus. Am I right about it? Oh, we can count on Jesus. Oh, yes, every last one of us can look and realize that the time that we've been unclean and assaulted spirit came back to us and made us worse than what we are. And here's some of the things that he brought when he came back into our life that wasn't there when we were young and we were innocent and we were just trying to live, but we played with the devil and stuff started to manifest in our life. What manifested in our life? The Bible says that now the works of the flesh are manifested, which are these. What? Adultery can manifest itself. Read.
Fornication.
Read.
Uncleanness. Lasciviousness.
Lasciviousness. Read.
Idolatry.
Hold on a minute. This verse 4 cover money, sex, power, and homosexuality.
Whoa.
He said when he came back to you, he said, last time I had you hooked on money. Look like you done decided got money. I know money got you. But you got away from it. But I slapped some power. Come on, power of spirit. Come on with me right quick. I need the same spirit that was in Saul. The same spirit that was in Diophantes. I need a power homie maniac spirit. Come on, we got to give him something he'll like. He'll get into it. And then not only that, but I need some fornication. Because I know he likes money, power, and some good love making. Simply, I need some of my best tricks to get up and come right now. And we're going to knock on that door. We're going to say, you're going to turn down all of this.
Well,
and there you sit. Playing, looking out the window. Man, when I used to make $10,000 a day, you know, man, I used to walk around with $5,000-$6,000 in my pocket, man. You know, I walked away from lady that wrestled. Walked away from it, man. Yeah. Devil Incorporated, we have an eviction notice. Right. Jesus Christ.